gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
California. Welcome to the Late Late Blue. I am your host, TV's Craig Perkins. All right, all right. Thank you very much. So, wow, what a big Friday night crowd we got in here tonight. Wow! 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 Friday is a great day for America, everybody. It's Friday! Great day for America, where it's Friday. It's been a crazy week. So many things have happened. I've started talking like William Shatner. I don't know when it's going to stop. Karl Rove stepped down this week. He said he wants to spend more time with his loved ones. I think I speak for us all when I say Karl Rove has loved ones. I think he's leaving now so he has plenty of time to steal Christmas. It was also... Take that, powerful politician. Do you know what happened this week as well? Van Halen announced they're getting back together with David Lee Roth. I'm very excited about it. It's been over 20 years. Very excited about that. Do we have a picture of Van Halen? There they are. Wow. Let me see that again, yeah. You know, David Lee Roth is looking great for a man his age, isn't he? No, he's good.
Might as well slump.
Here's what I want to talk about. There's a big movie opening today. Very big movie. It's called The Invasion. Can we see the poster? Yeah, there you are. Look, see? It's The Invasion. It's a remake of a classic sci-fi film of the 1950s. It was called Invasion of the Body Snatchers. It was remade before, sometime in the 80s as well. And they called it Invasion of the Booty Snatchers. It was a different type of movie. It wasn't bad, actually. I saw it 5 times. One night in a hotel. The original Body Snatchers movie is about aliens who would take over your body and clone you. I wouldn't want an alien taking over my body unless it was Antonio Banderas. For he is the forbidden alien. Relax your body, Craig. It's just like going to sleep. I don't know what that is. Pay no attention to my deformed hand, Craig. It's not part of the plot. It's just here for some reason. The special effects guy thought it would look good. I have no idea why it's here. Anyway, in this movie, The Invasion, the clones try to pass themselves off as human. But there's always something not quite right about them. I think, by the way, that's what happened to Kenny Rogers. Wait. 10 years ago, here's a picture of Kenny 10 years ago. There he is. Kenny Rogers. Everybody's favorite. Kenny Rogers. He knew when to hold them. He knew when to fold them. Right? Here's a picture of Kenny now. And this is what Kenny will look like in 10 years. Look at this. There he is. So... Of course, that was us using the latest computer imagery to... Anyway, I think someone's taken over my arm. The Invasion movie, it stars Nicole Kidman, and I really want to see it. Now, here's something I thought I would never say. I want to see the next Nicole Kidman movie. I've never really been... I mean, you know... I don't know why she bothers me. I think, you know, I put her on the big fag nows and won an Oscar. Do you ever notice how when she does... Maybe it's the Australian accent, because everything sounds like a question in Australia. No. Good eye, mate. I'm very drunk right now. My humps, my lovely lady lamps. Someone put cocaine in my pants. It's not even Australia. Yeah. Yeah, I know I shouldn't make fun of Nicole Kidman, because she's probably great in this movie. She's great at acting. She did her best acting performance ever was with A Creature from Outer Space. Did we have a picture of Nicole Kidman and The Creature from Outer Space? There you are. No, come on. That was a great performance, though, she gave with him, wasn't it? That was a great performance. Can I see that picture again? Hey, can I ask a question? Nicole Kidman is 5'11", right? And look at that picture. What's going on? It's well known Tom Cruise is borderline midget. Is he standing in a phone book? Is he on a phone book or is she on a... Is he just closer to the camera or something? Is she in a ditch, maybe? Anyway, that's... Hurry up and take the picture. My heels are getting maddy. It's not me doing that, it's the hand. Real life, though, is catching up to the body snatcher movies, because we're almost at the point now where you can clone people. Cloning, of course, started in Scotland. That's where they perfected it, it's true. They did, they cloned a sheep named Dolly. Made me mad when I heard that. It didn't really help the national stereotype, you know, of Scotland being full of sheep and... and guys who like sheep. It didn't help. You know, it doesn't help when you go, well, we can now develop cloning. What should we clone? Well, it should be something we already have lots of, so no one will notice. And we'll give it a woman's name. And then we'll finally be taken seriously as scientists and not just sheep shaggers. It's not true, by the way. It's not true. It's not true about the Scottish people and that business. It's not true. I hate sheep. I hate them, and I'm Scottish, and I hate sheep. They're stupid, and they're mean, and they're covered in matted brown animal hair. Do we have a picture of something stupid, mean, and covered in animal hair? There you go. No. Hell am I talking about? Invasion of the Body Snatchers. The Invasion of the Body Snatchers film is a classic science fiction movie. And I love all these science fiction movies, you know, of the 50s, you know, with their cheap sets and the bad lighting. Remind me of this show, really, in many ways. Because in the 1950s movies, all the aliens would come down with their powerful weapons to threaten the American way of life. Of course, it was all a metaphor for communism. Because everyone at that time was scared of the Soviets. We thought the Russians were drunk on power. Turns out they were just drunk, but we attacked.
Decadent capitalist, we will bury you. I love you, man. I love you. You don't know me.
Russia's changed, though, since the Soviet days. Capitalism has taken hold. They've got fast food over there. They've got Starbucks over there, which has completely changed Yakov Smirnov's act. In America, you order espresso. In my country, espresso orders you. Don't get me wrong, Russia's not exactly a place I'd like to live. It's a very hard life. The weather's cold. People have been ravaged by decades of drinking and fighting. Hard, cold, ravaged by decades of drinking and fighting. Remind you of anyone?
Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Capital One's new no-hassle cash rewards. What's in your wallet?
Welcome back, my naughty monkeys. There you go. That's right, that was a monkey. It was a monkey that had been cloned. Badly. Remember I was talking, you know what I was talking a minute ago about Russia? Remember I was, you know, talking about Russia? You remember, it was only just before the commercials. And weren't the commercials great, by the way? Weren't they lovely? What? You didn't see them. Anyway, welcome back to the big Friday show, isn't it? It's Friday. I can usually tell by the tie.
I went to Russia, is what I was going to say. I went to Russia once. I went to Russia to work once, about 5 years ago. And the only time I've ever been to an African restaurant was in Moscow. I went to an African restaurant. They call it an African restaurant, but you're figuring Africa's about the size of, you know, Europe. Bigger. It's huge. How can you have one restaurant for the whole... Anyway, I go to this African restaurant, and I ordered crocodile. Well, when you're in an African restaurant, you want to have something that... And it tasted suspiciously like Kentucky Fried Chicken. I've got to be honest. Don't get me wrong, it was delicious. It just didn't taste very crocodile-y. I just ordered it so I could say, give me the crocodile and make it snappy. Anyway, I did. Anyway, I'm talking to the... How would you like your crocodile? Oh, snappy. But I was talking to Russians of my own age when I was there, you know, in their early 20s. And I was talking to Russians and, I was telling them about, you know, when I grew up, when we grew up in the West and the propaganda about the Soviets, you know, how they were evil and stuff. And they said that they grew up with propaganda about us. This is true. They were told by the Soviet government that we would eat them. I know! With fava beans and a nice Chianti. Eat them? They thought we were going to eat them. They thought someday American bombers were going to fly over Moscow and season them. You know. There you go, you commie bastard. I hope you like paprika. And when I was in Russia, I thought it was very atmospheric. A lot of, you know, you think about spies and stuff. So I got a pair of binoculars so I could look, you know, at the Kremlin. So I was looking at the Kremlin with these binoculars on. I wanted to look at... Because the Kremlin's like the Playboy Mansion of communism. So I'm looking... Like that, through the Kremlin, and I saw a guard looking back at me through binoculars. With the same binoculars, looking like that back at me. It was really creepy. I was so creeped out, I put my clothes back on. We'll be right back, everybody. Welcome back. Welcome back, my naughty monkeys. I think that's a new one. Now, of course, this year, as everybody knows, it marks the 40th anniversary of 1967. The summer of love. 1967 was the summer of love. You see, so our good friend here at the show has a new book called Henry Winkler's Summer of Love. Please welcome and talk about that. Henry Winkler, everybody. Henry Winkler.
Thank you.
Henry. Now, Henry, of course, Henry, welcome. Now, I know you as a producer, an actor, a writer, a bon vivant, a carpenter, some would say. But I didn't know you were. I didn't know you'd written a book. What was the summer of love about, Henry?
It was about love, duh. It was also about ridding ourselves of our attachment to material things.
That sounds very idealistic. Yeah. Are you still live by that principle?
No, I made tons of money and I gave up on that crap.
All right. Lovely book though, isn't it? It's a lovely, lovely book. There's a cover there. Look at that. It's like it was yesterday, isn't it? Really. Free love, of course, was big at the time. Old free love. That'd be nice. Hey, what was that like?
Free love was fantastic up until I had to pay for it, you know? Yeah. And it got very expensive, even with coupons.
You use coupons for sex?
Well, Wednesdays were fantastic, too, because that was double coupon day.
Yeah.
you write the book then, Henry? Come on, why did you write
the
book?
Because my friends got really bored of my long, boring stories on the 60s. So I put them all into one volume and charged $34.95. And you can pick it up at any store, and I hope you do.
It's quite an outfit you're wearing on the cover there, Henry. That's
Well, you know, I mean, the clothing that we wore at that time, it's same color. Look at that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
But the clothing we wore, it was our way to express our individuality. You know?
I see.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's why we all wore the same thing. And we were rebelling.
I get it. It was like in the 1950s when people wore leather jackets and white T-shirts and jeans.
People wore what?
They'd grease their hair back and they'd wear, you know, motorcycle boots.
I would feel ridiculous dressed like that.
I have to tell you, it's quite tough to imagine you as a flower power hippie guy.
Oh, my goodness. We had so much fun, you know, just painting our naked bodies running through the Golden Gate Park.
Wow, it sounds like you were pretty wild back then.
Well, that was last weekend.
All right.
I want to just tell you, we had so much fun. Except getting arrested wasn't so much fun.
It rarely is.
No.
Yeah, yeah.
I felt very Paris-like.
They say that you... Actually, no. They say that you, if you can remember the 60s, you weren't really there.
Well, then I was definitely there because I don't remember anything.
So this is just, you know, you just made this up then. It's just
No. I used my... Excuse me. I used my diary. This is actual factual knowledge in here. As a matter of fact, let me just read. Let me just read. All right. Dear diary, the electric wizard is lying in jellyfish wisdom. And it's groovy.
No, I think that's enough for now. That's enough. Do you think? As I don't read anymore.
I just like being near my book.
It's fine over there. You don't want to get too close to it. It's, you know. Do you think we've learned anything since the Summer of Love?
Well, let's see. We haven't learned how to live together. We haven't learned to live in peace. But we have learned something very, very important. That is true.
What's that?
Women have got to shave their armpits.
You know, when you're right, you're right. Henry Winkler, everybody. We'll be right back. Back, my filthy pigeons. All right, that's enough of that. My first guest tonight, a terrific actress. She has two films opening this month. There's a drama called Death Sentence, and another film called Balls of Fury. Please welcome Aisha Tyler, everybody. Put your microphone on or else we'll never hear you.
I gotta put my little thing on.
I can help you with it if you want, if you need any.
That's just fine, thank you.
That's all right, I'm trained.
Yes. You're professional
creepy. Professionally creepy. I'm like,
how are you? I've been practicing for years.
Welcome to the show, Aisha. How are you?
I'm fantastic.
Really?
Yeah,
you
really
are
good.
Actually, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
What about the two films coming out at the same time?
Two movies coming out at the same time.
Have you been working very hard? You've been working very hard.
I've been working so hard. I've been running around with a sandwich board and symbols for me. See my movies. Da, da, da. But yeah, two movies. It's weird, wasn't it? All right, fine.
The leg thing.
Yeah, you ever seen that guy, that old-fashioned guy with like the harmonica and the cymbals between his legs?
No, where would I see this guy?
I don't know. In my head.
Yeah. You made him up. You made him up. The guy who bangs the cymbals together with.
There's a hurdy-gurdy.
Yeah. It's all right. Well, you should take. Have you taken a vacation or no?
No. You know, I just got back from vacation.
Really?
I've been working so hard. I took some time off. But you know how celebrities like take these kind of like fancy, like they go to St. Bart's or, you know, I don't know, Malaysia or Hawaii or whatever.
I truly wouldn't know.
Wouldn't know, yes.
Yeah, no,
I took a celebrity vacation this year to the Jersey Shore, which
nice.
Is rocking. Yeah, because that's how I do. Squish. Very fancy place I went to. And it's great because, you know, the Jersey Shore is not really fancy. You know what I mean? It's just like a kind of a family. My husband's family goes there every summer.
Right.
And it's great when you're there because nobody recognized me, because why would Aisha Tyler be, you know, kicking it on the beach at Sea Isle, you know? So right. People would walk. Literally, this girl came up to me in the store and she was like, and then she walked away. I was like, wait, it's me. Don't
yeah.
you?
Yeah. Well, maybe she thought you were someone else.
She might have.
Yeah,
but, you know.
I get it all the time. People come up and go, well, you're that guy. Oh, no, you're not.
No, not at all. Yes. Get my car. But it was fun, and I kicked it on the beach. I'll tell you what's great about going to the Jersey Shore.
Just a second. What does kicking it on the beach actually mean?
I don't know. I just thought it would sound cool.
Yeah, you thought it would sound cool.
Like people say that stuff. I look it up on the internet.
I don't know what kicking it on the beach really
means. I was, you know, sitting on the beach.
Kicking it,
just laying, you know, laying back.
Banging your little cymbals.
Yeah, banging my cymbals together.
All right, yeah.
And what's great about going to the Jersey Shore is that you're the hottest girl on the beach by far. Because it's all like 90-year-old ladies with like swim skirts on, like the hat with a little flower on the side.
Get me there.
But you'll see sometimes, see guys walking down the beach, you'll be walking down the beach and you'll be like, man, that girl is stacked. And then it'll be like, you know,
a guy.
A dude, totally. Yeah. It's awesome. Yeah. I'm like, it's kind of sad when there's guys on the beach that are like hotter than you.
Yeah.
Well, not hotter, but bigger is what I'm saying, you know.
It's the bane of my. I worry about having the he-hooters.
The man boobs? You're fearing the man boobs?
It haunts me in quiet moments when I turn over in bed at night. I think, oh, did they just flap? Have they arrived? Because you don't want.
No, I mean, you know, I think everybody likes boobs generally.
Sure. Who doesn't like boobs?
I mean, boobs.
Communists.
You know,
that's
exactly.
Who. Communists.
I think we can all agree that boobs are a party. I think we could agree on that. Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with boobs.
But you know, you'd like to keep it on one side. You know, not both sides of the bed. You know, and then there's just a fight. You know what I mean? Over who's like, you know, more fabulous.
Well, I don't know. I mean, there's certain situations where two sets of boobies is all. That's okay.
Hurdy-gurdy in your head.
Yeah, that's right.
Exactly.
That's just a little play.
Add some knee cymbals and then, you know.
Maybe knee cymbals. Yeah, all right. That'd be all right. So you went to the Jersey Shore and you...
What
part of the Jersey... Like the Atlantic City?
Like right near Atlantic City, yeah.
I've been to Atlantic City.
Have you? Do you gamble?
No, I don't gamble at all.
No?
I'm Scottish. You know?
Oh, yeah.
So, like, if someone, you know, the
you
deal
pinch
is,
your pennies.
You know, I give you money and you might give me some back.
Maybe.
No, that's...
Atlantic City is kind of like the kind of ugly old stepchild of Vegas, which is like...
I don't think that's fair. I think Atlantic City's rather nice, except there's just a lot of buildings that have got Trump written on them, which kind of puts me off.
Yeah.
Yeah, he writes his name on everything.
He's
like a three-year-old with a marker pen.
He wrote it on the side of my car the other day, which is kind of rude, I thought.
That's mine. Why did you do that? Do you write your name on stuff? She's just like, Tyler.
No. You know, I'm humble. I take it easy.
Are you humble?
Exactly.
Really?
I mean, I wrote it on my husband's ass, but that was in private. That wasn't for anybody to see. Mine, Tyler.
Well,
you know, stuff like that. He is gonna kill me.
What writing implement did you write on your husband's ass with?
Sharpie.
You should use a blunty.
Oh, well, yes. But as all college students know, the only writing implement that you use on human skin is the Sharpie. Impossible to erase.
Did you ever get drunk, so drunk that people drew glasses on you with a Sharpie when you were asleep?
But I did go out with a guy in college once who fell asleep drunk in my house, and my friends wrote all over his face.
Trump.
Loser. Yeah. Trump. Yes, exactly. Tyler. And then, you know, I hated to do it because he was in a vulnerable place, but you can't go out with a guy that's, you know, writing on his face.
Now, a guy with writing on his face, it's usually a giveaway.
Yeah, pretty much like...
Well, he's cute, but he's got writing on his face.
He's cute, but, you know, when he's in the mirror, he's reading himself, which is not a good thing. Yeah.
It's not a good thing. We have to take a break. We'll be right back. We'll be right back with Aisha Tyler. I'm here with the lovely once, twice, three times lady, Aisha Tyler.
Thank you.
Well, I just thought it'd be nice.
The serenade. You know what the kids would call that?
What?
Fly.
Fly? Mm-hmm. Really? I don't...
And if it was 1986, that's what they would call it, yeah.
Yeah, fly.
I'm behind on my newsletters.
Yeah, but it's the... wait, are you here now? Are you living in L.A. now?
I live here, yeah. Really? I travel all the time for work, but I'm here most of the time.
Have you embraced the L.A. lifestyle? Are you macrobiotic? I don't even know what that means.
I thought
microbiotic meant someone who was very, very small.
There's an ointment, I'm sure. Yeah. No, I'm not. You know, I try to eat really well when I'm at home, but you travel so much and you really can't get good food. And then, like, also, like, if I'm working a lot and I'm traveling, I forget to eat. And you ever had the thing where you...
Oh, stop. You forget to eat?
I
forget to eat?
Who forgets to eat? Well, you get crazy. It's not like you forget. It's like you can't get to the food, you know, like you're talking.
I can always get to the food.
Like
I have to feed the he-hooters. Feed them. Feed them. Feed us. We must stay alive.
She's bigger than me. I need to put on weight. But yeah, and so sometimes I'll get so hungry, and then, like, I'll just eat the first thing that's in front of me, which is usually, like, a cookie. And the other day, I was so hungry. I hadn't eaten in hours. I ate a brownie so fast, it was confused. It was like, what happened? Oh, God, I was out there, and I'm in here. Oh, God. I eat fast, very fast. Just two bites, just chocolate crumbs, and sadness afterwards.
Well, no. If I don't eat, like, if I eat sugar, but don't eat anything before the sugar...
Right. Crack.
Crack. Crazy.
Totally.
I just go crazy.
And I'm not like really that Hollywood, you know, because I like don't do drugs or drink or like drive around with, you know, my bra off and chase people down Wilshire Boulevard.
I guess I'm not Hollywood either.
No, exactly.
Apart from the bra, I do the bra thing.
Don't you feel left out? Like you need to fall asleep in a car? You know, I haven't done that yet.
You know what? I feel for those kids because I see like, you know, that Lindsay Lohan and stuff like that. Like, she's like 20 or something, 21, and she's lying like in her car, and I'm thinking, my God, if there were cameras around when I was that age, oh my
Seriously,
God.
I mean, it seems really dramatic and scary, but as we know, that was college, pretty much. Every day in college, we just didn't have anybody taking pictures of us.
Yeah.
That's the great thing about college is you can pass out and drool on yourself.
I never even went to college. I just went straight to blackout drinking.
Excellent. Yeah. Nice.
Whoa, what the hell is that? Wow, look at that.
That's good.
Is that an iPod?
I took it off of...
What the hell is that? Look at that thing.
And then I took it off of Lindsay Lohan when she's passed out in her car.
That's like a real Bond villain.
Like, I was like, and thank you, Lindsay. But no, I don't know what it is. I don't even know what it's made out of.
I like it.
But actually, when you lick it, it tastes like grape. So it's really nice.
You ever had it when you were a kid?
The little
candy ring? You've been so deprived.
I grew up in Scotland. We just, you know, there's your potato.
Exactly. Your potato on a stick.
That's your Christmas and your Christmas dinner.
Yeah, it's cold.
No, it's all right. Yeah, no. I really like that. It kind of looks like it would fire out a laser beam or something.
Yes, or maybe open it and there'd be like a little gun. Pew, pew. This is the Hollywood thing. You know, you have to dress up and be fancy and wear the rings and stuff like that. When I leave here, you're not going to recognize me. I'm going to look like a man. I'm going to take all this off and be like, RuPaul, come back.
I don't think that's true. But it's always lovely to see you. Aisha Tyler, everybody. We'll be right back. My next guest will be appearing at Morty's Comedy Joint in Indianapolis, Indiana, on October the 3rd to the 6th. Please welcome Dwayne Perkins, everybody. Dwayne Perkins.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. All righty. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you. Thank you very much, guys. You know, you got to, these days, you got to be careful when you're texting people because you can't always get the tone across on a text. So I'm texting my buddy. He's another guy. And I said something a little smart. Now, I know I'm texting a guy, but I'm thinking, you know, I don't want him to take it the wrong way. I'm going to venture out, throw the smiley face at the end of this thing. Now, I know I'm taking a risk, but I thought we were secure enough in our male-to-male relationship where I could throw the smiley face at the end of this. But on my phone, you get to pick which smiley face you want to send. And my finger slipped, and instead of sending the regular smiley face, I sent the winking smiley face. This one right here. Yeah. I was just trying to be considerate, and now we're dating, apparently. So that got a little weird. I'm from New York. I live in L.A. now. It's cool. Trying to make ends meet. I have a roommate. And, you know, when people live together, they're never equally clean. This is true. Like, clap tonight if you're the clean one in your situation. Clap. Who's the clean one out there? Yeah.
Yeah.
If you notice, the clean ones, they even clap clean, right? They're like, yes, I'm the clean one. I don't want to make any dust, but yes, I'm in fact the clean one. And the clean ones always look at the dirty one to make sure they're not clapping. No, you don't clap. It's not your turn to clap. Please. No, you're not clean. Please don't clean. I'm not the clean one. Matter of fact, clap if you're the not clean one tonight. I won't say dirty. Clap if you're the not clean one. Yeah. See that? That clap has more life to it, more vigor, right? I'm not the clean one, but I don't think I'm dirty. It's just that my roommate is anal. This guy doesn't live life. He stalks dirt, is what my roommate does. Yeah. Dirt has a restraining order against my roommate. It's true. He's always lurking in the shadows, waiting to clean something. Like, if I'm eating a sandwich, the phone rings, right? I run, get the phone, I come back, the plate, it's gone. It's in the dish rack. And he's not even home. Do you understand what I'm saying? And he's passive aggressive. He writes little notes. God forbid I don't wipe off the sink. That will get a note. Yeah. Right, and the note will be like, attention sink users, please keep sink area clean. And it's just me and him, so I'm not sure why he's saying sink users. Say Dwayne. It's crazy, though. I got friends of all race, colors. I think people need to get along. And, you know, people always think that it's only black and white that don't get along. But it's not true. It's like we need to do better as people. Like, even other races don't get along. Like Japanese, Korean. They don't necessarily get along. I'm not sure if you're aware. And, like, say you're a Korean girl. And you fall in love with if you're a Japanese girl, you fall in love with a Korean guy. What are you going to do? Your parents already said, right? But you love this guy. Well, here's what you do. Here's a little trick I came up with. You bring home a black guy. Yes. 2 weeks later, bring the Korean guy back. There'll be dancing and kimchi everywhere. Yakimandu. Oh, thank you. Now, here's the thing, though. Here's the trick. Now, what happens in that same situation if you fall in love with a black guy? What do? No one has any answers. See, that's messed up. Well, here's what you do in that situation. If you fall in love with a black guy, bring home Flavor Flav. Yeah, that's what you would do in that situation. 2 weeks later, bring me home, and your parents would be like, yeah, boy. They would have learned that from Flavor. I tell you guys, I don't drink. I'm a non-drinker. But I do not have a problem with drinking. So if you drink, that's cool. But sometimes people have a problem with me not drinking. Yeah, one guy said to me recently, he goes, I don't trust anyone who doesn't drink. And I was like, really? That seems a little harsh. I could see if he said, I don't trust anyone who doesn't blink. This is scary. Look at this. That's scary stuff. Right? Because if you don't blink all day, you're probably an alien. Am I right? Yes, I am. I don't care if it's your best friend you've been knowing since you're 2 years old. 8 hours go by, they don't blink, stab them. That's not your friend anymore. We just need alternatives to drinking. Drinking is cool, but like after my show, people always want to buy me a drink. But we can bond over anything. If you like me tonight, you don't got to buy me a drink. Why not buy me some cake? I like cake. Like, hey, that was pretty funny, man. Want some cake? Say like the Lakers win a championship, then the locker room celebrating. There's no champagne. Cake. Just cake. Yeah. Well, you know, in the third quarter, it got a little crazy. I mean... They made a run, then we made a run, and I think in the end, we wanted it the most. The cake. Right? And girls would all be like, I only smoke when I eat cake. Hey, you guys are great. I'm Dwayne Perkins. Thank you very much.
Welcome back. My
My next guests have already reached superstar status in their homeland, Australia. They're now releasing their first CD in the States. It's called Moo, You Bloody Choir, which is out now. Please welcome Augie March, everybody. Augie March.
Seen somebody you'd known since you're 16. If love is a bolt from the blue, then what is it bold but a glorified screw that doesn't hold nothing together? Far from these nonsense bars and that nowhere music, it's making me sick. And I know it's making you sick. There's nothing there, it's like eating, it's like drinking gin with nothing else in that doesn't hold me together. But for one cried it out, you were the only one in the room. Well, I sailed around all those bumps in the night to your beacon in the gloom. I thought I'd found my golden September in the middle of that purple June. But one cried it out would lead to my wreck and ruin. I know you like your boy, take their medicine from a bowl of a silver spoon. Who run away with the dish and scale the fish by the silver light of the moon. Who taught from the womb to believe to their tune and as far as their bleeding I see. Is it pleasure pen meant for them, building and rent for them, not for the likes of me? No, not for the likes of you and me. If no one cried it out, were you the only one in the room? But I sailed around all those bumps in the night, you're begun in the gloom. I thought I'd found my golden September in the middle of that purple dream.